It's no secret that 3D printing doesn't always put out the greatest things into the air that we breathe, and in some cases, it might just be downright dangerous. Now, I'm definitely no expert, and there's a handful of videos that go into this topic way deeper than I ever could. In fact, you should actually check out Thomas Sandler's Made with Layers video recently covering this topic. I'll have a link for that down below. You should check that out after watching this video. But in today's video, I'll be building this DIY air purifier known as the Bento Box. This box consists of some fans, a HEPA filter, and some activated charcoal. And if you're interested in printing and building one of these yourself, I'll have links down below for both the files and the actual materials that you'll need to build this. Now, the purpose of this build is to help reduce any particulate matter or VOCs that come from 3D printing. And while you probably don't need this when you're printing with PLA, it does have the potential to really help when printing with ASA or ABS, which is something that I do from time to time. From my understanding, these are some of the worst filaments that you can print with. I do print some ASA and ABS from time to time, so I did build this to help with those filaments and make it just a little bit safer, hopefully. Now, printing these are super easy. Ideally, you want to print these in something other than PLA. You're gonna need that temperature resistance of something along the lines of PETG or even something a little bit more resistant. Now, for my build, I went with the Bambu Lab's new PETG High Flow. So far, I found it incredibly easy to print with, and it just comes out looking so good, what can I say? If you're interested in watching a video on the PETG High Flow, let me know down in the comments below, and maybe I'll make a video on that here in the future. Now, if you wanted to print these in some more exotic materials, but you didn't actually want to deal with printing them, you could use the sponsor of today's video, PCBWay. Over on PCB's website, you could upload the files and select the material you wanted it printed in. They have material as simple as PLA or as crazy as PEEK or even titanium. They also offer other services like CNC machining, injection molding, or even some sheet metal services. You know, I actually wonder if a CNC'd metal version of this Bento Box would be possible and how cool that might be. Thanks to the folks over at PCBWay, that could actually be a possibility. And thanks again to them for sponsoring today's video. Now, all in all, the printing only used up about 300 grams of filament and took about 14 hours. Like I said, I printed this in the Bambu Lab's PETG High Flow in both green and yellow. Why I chose those colors, I don't know. I actually kind of don't like this color combo. I wish I would have done something else, to be honest with you. Now, to make this whole system work, we're gonna need some specific items. We're gonna need some heat inserts, some magnets, a HEPA filter, some 4020 fans, and some activated carbon. And I'm actually gonna have links for all those down in the description below, so you don't have to go searching for them. Now that we have everything printed, we can start installing the 4x2mm magnets, and you're gonna be doing this quite a bit. You have to install 32 magnets. Now, installing the magnets here is crucial that you put them in with the right polarity, because if you do it wrong, rather than attracting, they're going to repel each other. So one trick that I found is I would get them lined in, as you can see here, and then I would take the bottom part of that whole stack and start using that bottom part to start feeding into the next part that would connect to it. And the moment of truth to making sure that I got these lined up right. Got them lined up right, but unfortunately, I realized that I needed to use super glue to keep the magnets in. And there's no way of doing this without getting super glue all over your fingers. So I'm going with about 475 on my temperature to put in these heat inserts. I have not had very good luck with doing this in the past, so this should be fun. Hey, that looks pretty good actually. But I guess having the right temperature makes a big difference. Just putting in a bit of pressure to kind of push it down. And I'm just trying to get it to be where it's just below the lip. Let it heat up for a second and then I'm pushing down. So for this fan, it looks like I need an M3
by 25. Uh-oh. Do I have one? All right, so unfortunately, I don't have a 25 millimeter one. I only have a 20 and a 30. So I'm going to use a 30, but put 5 washers and hope that this works. It's a little janky, but that's what we do here. I mean, I guess that'll work. All right, so just double check. It's important to make sure that it blows down. So we want the airflow this way. Yep. I got some of these wire connector T-taps, whatever they're called. But it'll allow us to run one wire for everything. Ah, try this again. I reseated the stuff in the T-tap. And we have spinning fans. Sweet. All right, next up, I've got this activated carbon that should work for this. Okay, I've got my C-mag, and from my understanding is we just throw the carbon in here. Yeah, it looks like I did miss a point. They actually suggest gluing in these things. So we're gonna add a little glue in here. There's nothing up. And there is a fill line indicator. You can see right there. So we fill it up a little bit. Whew. That does not look like a bag of fun. That looks like a mess. One. That's probably too much. Whoops. Cool, close enough. Let's throw this back on here. Oh, I just realized I never magnetized these. Crap. All right, let's do that real quick. All right, so now I think we can close this up. And there we go. Now our C-mag is full of carbon. There's my carbon slot. HEPA filter on top. And then we can go on here. Bam, our bento box is done. Let's try this thing out, shall we?
So like I said in the intro of this video, this was not going to be very scientific. But what I can say is that with the bento box inside the printer, I think it does a good job of really helping purify the air faster than if you just relied on the built-in system of the Bambu Lab's X1 Carbon. Now for my test here, I told the printer to extrude ASA, which caused the error monitor to go crazy. And after a course of time, you can see that the air quality levels returned back to normal. Was it worth it? Yeah, I think so. Plus, projects like these are quite fun to do. Now, let me know down in the comments below if you have built one of these and if you've actually noticed a difference. I really am curious to see what everyone's thoughts are on this. Thanks for watching today. This is Adam, and I'll see you next time.